falls is such a common problem. We know that about 60% of people with Parkinson's will fall annually, and 2/3 of people will fall recurrently, i.e. they'll have more than one fall. And I remember very pertinently one lady saying she was just so worried about her husband's walking that effectively they had to walk everywhere together to go to the bathroom, to try and leave the house. Their whole world had really shrunk right down to the point where they were literally confined to the house just because of this risk of falling. And of course the consequences once a fall's occurred can be so devastating. I ran a phase 2 trial that looked at a drug called rivastigmine, which is a capsule that we use to treat patients with dementia. And we looked at 130 patients with Parkinson's and examined whether rivastigmine could improve their walking steadiness and potentially prevent them falling over. And we found that actually being treated with rivastigmine compared to placebo or dummy capsules actually improved your gait variability, so your walking was steadier. But most excitingly, this translated to a really important reduction in your rate of falling. So we saw that treatment with rivastigmine reduced your rate of falls by 45%, which is a real groundbreaking bit of result that we've come to from the trial. The next step is to reproduce these findings on a larger scale, so recruiting far higher numbers of people, probably in the region of 400 to 500 people, and looking at falls in all of them and seeing whether actually on a larger scale we see the same results. If I was to do the same walk in teeteringly high heels, as you can see on the picture here, I would necessarily slow my walking down and might not be so confident about doing all those other things at the same time.
Exercise has been shown in research to have real benefits to help manage symptoms. It's a very important part of everyone's lifestyle.